Facts about nature. If you see one of these clouds in the sky, run away quickly. Supercell, the king of thunderstorms, they can fling out tornadoes and more. Tornadoes are one of the most feared weather events on Earth. These quick-forming and normally short-lived cyclones tend to emerge from strongly rotating thunderstorms known as supercells. Hello, I am Hannah. Welcome to Hannah Fact Channel. In this video, we want to talk about beautiful but dangerous clouds. When the threat of severe weather looms, clouds are often the first sign that skies are turning unfriendly. Look for the following types of clouds during disturbed weather. Recognizing them in the severe weather they're linked to could give you a head start to finding shelter. Once you know which clouds are related to severe weather and what they look like, you'll be one step closer to becoming a storm spotter. Number 1. Cumulonimbus clouds are thunderstorm clouds. They develop from convection, the transport of heat and moisture upward into the atmosphere. But, whereas other clouds form when air currents rise several thousand feet and then condense where those currents stop, the convective air currents that create cumulonimbus are so powerful, their air rises tens of thousands of feet, condensing rapidly, and often while still journeying upward. The result is a cloud tower with bulging upper portions that look something like cauliflower. If you see a cumulonimbus, you can be sure there's a nearby threat of severe weather, including bursts of rainfall, hail, and possibly even tornadoes. Generally, the taller the cumulonimbus cloud, the more severe the storm will be. Number 2. Anvil clouds. An anvil cloud isn't a standalone cloud, but more of a feature that forms at the top of a cumulonimbus cloud. The anvil top of a cumulonimbus cloud is actually caused by it hitting the top of the stratosphere, the second layer of the atmosphere. Since this layer acts as a cap to convection, the cooler temperatures at its top discourage thunderstorms. The tops of storm clouds have nowhere to go but outward. Strong winds high up fan this cloud moisture, so high up that it takes the form of ice particles, out over great distances, which is why anvils can extend outward for hundreds of miles from the parent storm cloud. Number 3. Mammatus clouds mean a wild ride. Mammatus clouds produced by a nearby thunderstorm. If you ever encounter mammatus clouds, chances are you just experienced horrible weather or you're about to go through a wild ride pretty soon. These numerous, bulbous protrusions hanging high in the sky beneath a deck of clouds look like the mammary glands of a cow or human, hence their name. These clouds are thought to form due to intense turbulence produced by the strong thunderstorm, leading to their smooth, bubbly appearance. When seen in association with thunderstorm clouds, they're typically found on the underside of anvils. Number 4. While clouds form under the rain-free base, bottom, of cumulonimbus clouds. It takes its name from the fact that it resembles a dark gray wall, sometimes rotating, that lowers down from the base of the parent storm cloud, usually just before a tornado is about to form. In other words, it is the cloud from which a tornado spins. While clouds form as the thunderstorm updraft draws in air near the ground from several miles around, including from the nearby rain shaft. This rain-cooled air is very humid and the moisture within it quickly condenses below the rain-free base to create the wall cloud. Number 5. Shelf clouds appear in spring and summer. These formations roll across the horizon like a shelf or a wedge suspended just above the surface, immediately preceding heavy rain and wind. Shelf clouds form as a result of rain-cooled air descending from a thunderstorm and hugging the ground like a bubble. This creates an outflow boundary, which acts like a mini cold front scooping up warm air ahead of it. The shelf cloud forms at the ridge of the pool of cold air, creating a striking scene. Like wall clouds, shelf clouds also form underneath thunderstorm clouds. As you can imagine, this fact doesn't help observers differentiate between the two. While one is easily mistaken for the other to the untrained eye, cloud spotters know that a shelf cloud is associated with thunderstorm outflow, not inflow like wall clouds, and can be found in the storm's precipitation area, not rain-free area like walls clouds. Number 6. Funnel cloud. This is a funnel-shaped cloud of condensed water droplets, associated with a rotating column of wind and extending from the base of a cloud, usually a cumulonimbus or towering cumulus cloud, but not reaching the ground or water surface. A funnel cloud is usually visible as a cone-shaped or needle-like protuberance from the main cloud base. Funnel clouds form most frequently in association with supercell thunderstorms, and are often, but not always, a visual precursor to tornadoes. Funnel clouds are visual phenomena, these are not the vortex of wind itself. Number 7. Scud clouds. That aren't dangerous clouds in and of themselves, but because they form when warm air from outside of a thunderstorm is lifted up by its updraft, seeing scud clouds is a good indication that a cumulonimbus cloud, and hence, a thunderstorm, is nearby. Their low height above ground, ragged appearance, and presence beneath cumulonimbus and nimbus stratus clouds mean scud clouds are often mistaken for funnel clouds. But there's one way to tell the two apart. Look for rotation. Scud do move when caught in the outflow, downdraft, or inflow, updraft regions, but that motion typically is in rotation. Number 8. Roll clouds. Roll or argus clouds are tube-shaped clouds that literally look like they've been rolled up into a horizontal band across the sky. They appear low in the sky and are one of the few severe weather clouds that are actually detached from the storm cloud base. This is one trick for telling them apart from shelf clouds. Spotting one is rare, but will tell you where a thunderstorm's gust front or another weather boundary, like cold fronts or sea breezes, lay, since these clouds are formed by outflows of cold air. Those in aviation may recognize roll clouds by another name, morning glories. Number 9. Wave clouds. Wave, or Kelvin-Helmholtz clouds, resemble breaking ocean waves in the sky. Wave clouds are created when air is stable and winds at the top of a cloud layer are moving faster across it than those below it, causing the top clouds to be whipped around in a downward curling motion after hitting the stable layer of air above. While wave clouds aren't related to storms, they are a visual cue for aviators that a large amount of vertical wind shear and turbulence are in the area. Number 10. Asperitus clouds. Asperitus are another cloud type that resembles a roughened sea surface. They appear as if you were underwater looking upward toward the surface when the sea is particularly roughened and chaotic. Although they look like dark and storm-like doomsday clouds, asperitus tend to develop after convective thunderstorm activity has developed. Much is still unknown about this cloud type, as it is the newest species to be added to the World Meteorological Organization's International Cloud Atlas in over 50 years. Thank you for being with us so far. Do not forget to subscribe us and activate the HANAFACT channel bell to be the first to see our videos. Share your views on the video with us and introduce us to your friends. I love you very much.